Hey guys, so I finally decided what to do for a mukbang video. So today it is, what date is today? July 11th. And so today for dinner it is grilled wraps. And so this is the homemade grilled wraps. And I don't know, it's just what I felt like. And the drink is this blue stuff. It's just a blueberry. Oh, can you guys hear that thunder? Oh my word. It's not Matthew making sound effects this time. It's the thunder making sound effects this time. It says blueberry watermelon juice. And so as you guys can... as you guys can guess, this grilled wraps, for me, grilled wraps is like somehow like a comfort food sort of for me. I really, really love grilled wraps. So today's grilled wraps, the filling, it is the deli meat, the smoked chicken deli meat, and salsa and cheese. So if you guys are wondering, why am I not dipping it with ketchup? Like today has been just one of those days that just feels very long and annoying sort of days, and so I just felt like wraps. So this is what it looks like, the wraps. So my other favorite topping for wraps, I love to use that imitation crab meat. Oh my gosh, I can eat that like candy. I could eat a million of them. And one of my other favorite fillings for wrap is smoked salmon, but smoked salmon is so expensive. How much salsa did you add? Did you not add much? It's not too spicy.
There's hardly any salsa.
We do have a new jar in the cupboard. Yep. There's just something about grilled wraps that can hits the spot. Like for me, unless it is like a very, very special ingredient that they put in it in the restaurants, wraps and stuff is one of those things that I do not, I never order wraps in a restaurant because I know I can make my own wraps. I can put whatever the F wraps I like, fillings I like in the wraps at home. Ooh. You know what would have been good with this wraps too? Soup. Like a tomato soup or something. Right? Because yes, on the last vlog, we had wraps for dinner last night, and we had salad, and we had the potato wedges. It was the vlog that we went to for the that we did for the stampede. And it is so weird because I went to the Stampede all by my lonesome this year because my other usual girlfriends that I go with, she is working this week and she only has the kids' day off, and so she's going on kids' day. And because I am cheap, the only day I ever want to go to Stampede if I feel like it is on Family Day. Oh, and if you guys watch my video, the Stampede video, I just realized I did not even wear the Western gear to Stampede. I just wore the t-shirt and my hoodie zipper thing, majiggy. But I am glad that I did not wear too much crap that day because it was actually a pretty nice day. Just until I went back to the car at 5 something. And then the clouds started rolling in. But on the Sunday, it was a nice day for most of the day and it was so hot. And people was actually taking out their umbrellas to cover themselves from the heat, for the shade. And oh, you guys, like, for the next mukbang after this mukbang, you guys should be looking forward to this because I finally bought this rotisserie machine that I wanted this last few years. It's just like getting a tattoo, right, guys? You think about it for the last few years before you actually go and get the tattoo. So it's the same idea with this rotisserie machine. And because I was thinking, because with the way that how crazy the stuff is these days, like, sometimes there is the stores that come back again to the stampede every year. But anytime these vendors, they can decide not to come back again. And the time that you do want to buy it, then you never see them again. And I do know that on Amazon, they have other similar, well, they have the same brand, the models and stuff, but buying it from the Stampede is like getting it directly from the supplier. And so if there's any problems, you can get back at them and you can go after them if there's any problems. And if you buy it on Amazon, you're gonna have to deal it with Amazon, which would be a different situation probably. So I probably decided it would be better to get the authentic stuff from the official supplier. And also, I was scared to order the stuff online this month because they kept on saying the Canada Post thing might strike. And the latest thing they say, they're gonna lock them out. And now they say now they're gonna have a 30-day cool down period. And then because everybody got scared, right? All the Canadians got scared, right? And so the Canada Post made a new statement, and then they say, on Monday, the Canada Post staff returned to work on Monday, and it's a much less workload from Monday. It's like, duh, wonder why. Because you guys was always warning us, and we're not sure if to send any mail or not. And so this time, the Canadian government says they will not step in because the last time the Canada Post went on strike, the government forced them to go back to work. So yeah, and it was so funny, like, that rotisserie machine, we only parked about a block and a half away from the Stampede, and I was looking like a weird Asian guy, lugging around a big honking box, like, lugging and like, chugging along. I was probably giving people entertainment anyways when they saw me lugging it around. I I do not remember the box to being that big all these years, seeing this thing at the Stampede show. Oh, and so apparently this model of the rotisserie machine that I bought, it is the normal one. And then the girl told me what the difference was, and they also now have a deluxe model now too. I honestly couldn't tell you what the difference is. I'm really, really excited to be able to make the rotisserie style, restaurant style pork. Oh, and the beauty of this rotisserie machine that I bought is they include you with this tray. They include you with this baking pan. And so if you don't like to use it as a rotisserie, you can use it as a roast, like a pan. And the cooking process will be all the same. It's like the air fryer process. And then it is like an electric plug-in. And you don't need to worry about heating up the house, turning on the oven, or watching the stovetop. And with the baking pan that they provide you, you can also make like casseroles and stuff in it too. Like you put in another casserole dish and you can make casseroles too. So it seems like to be almost like an extra oven you buy. There's some of the filling to show you guys. Like, I don't know why I chose to buy this brand of wraps. I always buy the ones that is like at least a week from the expiry date, but every time, by the time we get to the middle of the package, it always gets a moldy spot. Do you guys hear the thunder? Besides my eating? Did any more lightning strikes hit Matthew? Because apparently on Saturday with the thunderstorms that we got, there was a 5 things that got hit on the ground. Oh, and thank you guys so much for liking my haircut. I'm getting a lot of comments about my haircut. As always, thank you so much. And I hope you guys enjoy watching my Calgary Stampede 2016 video. I called it the donut grilled cheese because that's what I had for lunch that day. The one thing that annoyed me this year about the Calgary Stampede is like almost all of the food places was frickin' cash only. One of the reasons I went to this donut grilled cheese place because it's one of the few places that took card payment. Like, I'm crazy, but I'm not that crazy. Like, I don't feel comfortable carrying a large wad of cash in a large crowd area, even though Calgary is still a pretty safe city. But it is like the tourists and stuff from different areas in the world that might take advantage of you. So no way, Jose, am I gonna carry a huge wad of cash in a crowded area. So the places that do not take card payment, they can just shove it. Because I am not using the bank machines that they offer because...
they kill you on fees.
Because the bank that I use is not with the bank they're sponsored with, and so it's gonna be so stupid on the fees, and I'm not that stupid to pay fees. Like, as if we need to give the banks any more money, right, guys? Matthew, how did you not burn these wraps?
I didn't leave them on.
Because for...
I watched them.
For me, I usually like to wait till I see the cheese and stuff oozing out. Like, did I say that already? Gosh, I got short memory. So apparently the donut grilled cheese is one of the new food of the Calgary Stampede this year. It was okay, it's like meh. And there was something wrong with their poutine, actually. I did not say it in the vlog because I don't think they let the cheese curds sit around for a while because the cheese curds were still cold. And it did not melt with the gravy. I think it was still a bit early for poutine. I think the cheese curds have to be in room temperature to make it the perfect poutine, right? Any poutine experts out there? I actually did not really like the poutine that I had yesterday. The cheese curd was still cold. But once again, that was the only place that took card payment. Even though, it came from the same poutine company that runs in the park. And also, the other thing that I always do when I go to the Stampede is, no way, Jose, do I pay for the bottled water. I'm not that stupid either. I bring my own water and I use the water fountain to refill. Duh. I always feel so sorry for the people that is buying the bottled drinks that I see. Or, I don't want to burst their bubble, but sometimes I feel like going up to them and say, hey, you know the grocery store sells the same thing at a cheaper price? Like, seriously? But sometimes I just don't want to be that nosy and I just mind my own business. But that's what I'm thinking.
Down.
These wraps are so delicious. Like, for me, the Stampede is like more of a normal thing, not too crazy, but one of you guys commented on that video that you have never gone to the Stampede before and it looks interesting for you. Thank you so much for that lovely comment. That is why I still make videos for you guys, because I know some of you guys will find it interesting. And like my parents, they think I'm weird that I bring the camera everywhere. They still don't understand the concept, what I'm doing and stuff. it's just so amazing how, like, I got people watching from all over the world. Like, I'm not one of those, like, huge mega channels, but, I do have a nice mix of people. So thank you so much to all you guys for tuning in today. And I'm seeing a few new subscribers here and there trickling in this week. So welcome to the new subscribers. Thank you for tuning in. Those wraps was good. It just hit the spot. And it's raining again like a downpour out there. We drove by the river yesterday, the Bow River, when we were headed towards Stampede to the downtown. And the river was actually pretty high looking. It's pretty high. Well, I surely hope so with all the rain that we've been having. Whoa. Sound effects for me today. Yeah. Whoops, excuse me. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Don't forget that I got a Mukbang video playlist and I got a playlist of all my other older videos. Thanks for watching and I'll see you guys soon.